It's the same old tune, fiddle and guitar. Where do we take it from here? Rhinestone suits and new shiny cars. It's been the same way for years. We need to change.
Hello, welcome to the Moving Iron Podcast. Kind of a special weather update here. I want to get Kirk Hinz on from BAM Weather here to talk about what's going on with Hurricane Florence and some of the some of the harvest stuff we see happening out there with that kind of getting ready to be in full swing. So, Kirk, what do you see happening out there, and how bad's Florence going to be, and is it everything everybody has talked about so far?
Yeah. So, basically, to recap Florence for all intents and purposes, it was a Category 4, almost a Category 5. It hit the coast kind of in Category 2 and a Category 1 hurricane. It definitely has been and has lived up to the hype. This was never going to be one of those hurricanes with 150-mile-an-hour winds hitting the coast. What we're really worried about is, A, the trend downpours of some areas getting near 40 inches of rainfall, and then, B, deadly storm surge there that it can raise the water 10 feet above the surface, which is over a ton of buildings inland there, and it's going to hover probably across the parts of the Southern Carolina coast till about Saturday to Sunday there. So it's just the longevity of the storm and the flooding rain. It's just a terrible situation down there, and especially it's a high population area as well. So, and not good. I think it's been well modeled, well forecast, and I was really proud of how everybody kind of just helped each other out and got the word out about it.
Are they still calling for the 30-plus inches of rain? I mean, is that still forecast by the way?
Yeah, some areas have already topped 20 inches there to the Carolina coast. So I think inland with kind of more influence with mountains, I mean, 40 plus. I would not be shocked by some areas getting 40 plus inches and the storm surge. I mean, we're going to be dealing with a lot of damage down there just from water.
So how far inland were they? I know they, when I saw it, they were kind of projecting it to be up into, if it hits shore at a Category 4, that they were talking like into like Tennessee almost. So you're still Category 2, Category 3 kind of phase of that storm. Are they still same kind of concept?
It's not going to be a strong hurricane. In fact, it's probably going to weaken to a tropical storm just because the interaction with land, what it does is it really just weakens the actual system. But that does not take away from the actual impacts of it. Like I said, we're dealing with a ton of water. Storm surge, everything in the slow motion of it is the dangerous part, is because people think, oh, it's only a tropical storm, I'm not going to worry about it. But then we get 20 inches of rain across South Carolina, and then, like you said, we're going to move up across Georgia and then Tennessee, and then it's going to recurve off into the northeast coast, impacting parts of Kentucky and West Virginia, Virginia, and those areas up there. So the slow motion of it is very deceiving because it doesn't look that impressive on radar, but it's just how slow it's moving, dumping a ton of rainfall.
All right, so now that's going to affect a lot of harvesting. Obviously, North and South Carolina are going to be affected to the point where, it's probably going to be devastate those crops down there. So let's talk about what you see other things happening in the Corn Belt and throughout the region.
Yeah, so great news over the past week, as we've been forecasting for you guys. It's been really, really dry, and it's been warm. It's been absolutely ideal conditions for harvest, really getting going, especially across parts of eastern Nebraska, Iowa, northern Missouri, Illinois that got swamped with all that rain. I mean, heck, even us, we got 5 to 6 inches of rain just last weekend, so it couldn't have come at a better time, all this dryness here. We are watching the pattern to get more active into next week, early to mid next week, especially, I would say, across the north central plains. I think there's a couple fronts in there, too, that could cause a little bit of some harvest delays, but overall, I think the pattern as we continue into October, it will be hitting this rainfall, but I think that we can continue to progress harvest and continue these above normal temperatures in there as well.
Good. Well, the above normal temperatures part's good to help finish that crop off, but the rain stuff can hold off for a little bit,
Well, we've had our fair share this season.
Absolutely. All right, Kirk, well, you know what? Guys want to get a hold of you and find out some more stuff that BAM Weather can do for them. Where can they do that at?
Yeah, feel free to get a hold of me on my own personal Twitter or our BAM Twitter, BAMwx.com, or we have a website, BAMwx.com as well. We've got samples on there. We've got contact information. We'd love to help you guys in any fashion, and I really appreciate having me on here as always.
Yeah, and if you want to see a good example of what that looks, go to 21stCenturyEquipment.net and check that out. Kirk and the fellas put together a daily forecast for us, so it's a good stuff and a lot of good information there, and I don't leave the house without watching it. So, Kirk, it's always a pleasure having you on, man.
Appreciate it, man. I hope you guys have a blessed weekend.
All right, you too, buddy. Take care of yourself.
Yep, see you.
Goodbye.
Moving higher in the 21st century. Hardworking people working hard for you and me. Moving higher time and time again. Through the years you'll find us here. Move.